We are looking at JavaScript question and answer. First is, what is the relationship between JavaScript and ECMAScript? So the relationship is, they are the similar. Means ECMAScript is just a name, yet another name of JavaScript. Other names, they include LiveScript. So we have presently, because maybe by the time you'll be going through this video, it may happen that some revision may be there, but presently it is revision 3. What are JavaScript types? So we have number, string, boolean, function, object, null, undefined. These are all JavaScript types. And please understand that JavaScript is an object-based language. Object-based language. So everything is object here. Language. How do you convert between or numbers between different bases in JavaScript? So we use the parseInt function, and this takes the string as the first parameter and the base as the second parameter. So string here and the base. So to convert, say, hexadecimal 3f to decimal, so you can just use 3f and then your 16, that is the first parameter is your 3f and base as the second one. How does this NaN, you will come across this NaN number of times. What does this NaN function do? This returns to if the argument is not a number. So NaN stands for not a number. So this is going to return you true for that. What is negative infinity? Negative infinity, it's a number in JavaScript which is derived by anything which you divide by zero. So you have, say, any negative number, so it essentially should be a negative number, and if you divide it by zero, it becomes a negative infinity. What boolean operators does JavaScript support? We have this AND, OR, NOT. These are the boolean operators that JavaScript support. What do this double quotes 1 plus 2 plus 4 will evaluate? It is going to evaluate 1, because 1 is a string. So everything is a string. So the result will be 1, 2, 4. 1 is a string, everything will be taken as string, and that they will be concatenated. How about 2 plus 5 and then double quotes 8? So these 2 and 5, they are integers. So the number, and this is the number arithmetic. Since now 8 is a string, it will be a concatenation. So 2 and 5 will give a 7, and then it will be concatenated by this plus sign with 8. So this will be 78. What looping structures are there in JavaScript? In JavaScript, you will find for, while, do while. You don't have any for each there. How do you create a new object in JavaScript? For that, you use this where object, new object, or you can directly do in shortened form, where, like this, obj is equal to non brackets. How do you assign object properties? It's quite simple. Obj, and this is your object, and this is your property. You assign a number here. Object.age is equal to 17. As I said, JavaScript is an object-based language. What's a way to append a value to an array? So this arr.length value. So this is how you append a value to an array. So array gets more value now. What is this keyword? You might have come across this word, this keywords. It is going to refer to the current object, whichever object we are dealing with. So let us, apart from this, learn about some more things. JavaScript gives HTML designers a programming tool. So HTML authors, they're not programmers, but JavaScript is a scripting language, very simple syntax. So anyone, almost anyone can put small snippets of code into their HTML pages. JavaScript can react to events. So a JavaScript can be set to execute when something happens, like when the page will be finished or loading or user clicks something, HTML element, what is going to go. So it gives dynamicity to the page, HTML page, which is anyway static. JavaScript can read and write HTML elements. So JavaScript can read and change the content of the HTML element, get element by ID and set inner text, inner HTML like this. JavaScript can be used to validate data. So a JavaScript can be used to validate form data when it is submitted to a server. So this saves the extra processing time for the server. A JavaScript can be used to detect the visitor's browser. A JavaScript can be used to detect which is the browser, and depending on upon the browser, it will load some another page specifically designed for that browser. And JavaScript can be used to create cookies. JavaScript can be used to store and retrieve information on the visitor's computer. How do I let people download a page from a file from my page? So once the file is uploaded to the server, you just need to have an anchor reference tag to link to it, nothing more. What is an empty HTML tag? Now this is important. Before that, let me give you the link how you're going to do. You just have anchor, then href. This is where your file is download. You will press, or the user will press, and it will be downloaded. What is an empty tag? Now let us come to this question. Empty tag or empty HTML tags are tags that do not need to be closed when one is creating an HTML document, right? Like br, like hr, you don't have to close it, because for say h1 you have to close it like this. For say img, you don't need to close it. Image, you don't need to close it. There is no img closing tag. So these are very quick recap of few questions. We have not comprehensively covered it. If you like it, I'll maybe covering it in more detail. Thank you so much. Take care.